So we're in Fleetwood Football Ground at the moment, which is going to be the home for this anti-fracking.
For Frack Free Sunday.
Yeah.
It's a lovely ground, isn't it? And hopefully we'll have a full stadium on the day.
Yeah, it sounds like it's going to be a pretty good event. So what made you want to get involved?
What, with the football club, you mean?
With the event in general?
Well, it all started, it was a strange day actually, because we come down to Blackpool, we got invited down by Cheryl and the Fleetwood anti-fracking return, and he asked if we would come down, and there's a meeting being held by a diplomat and a local Labour council, Blackpool Labour council, had been brought down to have a talk about fracking and how we can prevent fracking and what actions we can take to do fracking. And generally it was a talk about some of the things we can do about fracking, and at the same time Cheryl said to me, Andy, who's the chairman of the football club, asked me would I come and give him a visit with you doing the end of season celebrations for the football club, because I like Andy a lot actually, because he supports his local community, he's passionate about football, he's a proper working class man who cares for where he lives. So obviously we got down there, we see Bez Gas, right, my pal goes, bloody hell, Bez Gas, and we had to ask him what his position was on fracking. And the most amazing thing, he is against fracking, because obviously he's a local lad, he lives in the area, he's got kids there, and he knows it's an unsafe technology, and he gets all his gas from the North Sea, which, by the way, we've got a 40-year pocket left in the pocket we're using presently, and they've just found there's another pocket what they found with another 60 years worth of gas. So our North Sea gas supplies are fit, strong, healthy, and ready to go to supply the nation to see it through to renewable energy. So he asked us, would I get involved with the club with the end of season celebration? He wants to put a party on for the people of Fleetwood Football Club and Fleetwood itself. And of course he said yes, because he was an anti-fracker, and he's agreed to let his stadium and Fleetwood Football Clubs to come out against fracking.
So then, with the anti-fracking side of things, there seems to be three communities for the against argument. The first of which, you always get them, and that's the doom and glooms. End of the world. One person told me. The second one is the ones that are more informed.
Yeah.
And it's the actual process that they don't like. And then the third group is the side that actually they don't like the thought of tapping into yet another natural resource. So whereabouts do you fall on?
Well, where I fall is I came to fracking because, first of all, I've been living this permacultural existence, sharing land in a small community, growing all my old food organically, and creating energy, looking at ways of creating different energies. I built one community already like that. I've got another piece of land where I'm going to build another small community where it comes together. My idea is to get all these small little communities living off grid, trading amongst each other with free food, free energy, and your basic needs taken care of by producing everything yourself, you know what I mean, and acting as community. So I've been looking in it, living and experimenting in this lifestyle where money is less important and community activity is the key word, you know what I mean, where you help and live and act as community. Because what's happened is over the years it's been slowly torn apart. People don't go in pubs no more because it's too it. No, and all things of community nature have been like at the heart torn out of it, really, you know what I mean? So we want to try and rebuild this old ideal of living in community and not just for yourself, you know what I mean? It acts in for others as well as yourself. It's old fashioned, it works, and it brings about goodwill, you know what I mean? And happiness, and people actually saw what this is where I was coming from. And then I got asked down to Barton Moss about the fracking, and I have been watching it quietly from the sidelines, thinking that the technology that's that insane. They will actually bring it to our country because it, look how beautiful the place we live in. It's that, like you say, green and pleasant land. It's gorgeous, beautiful. We were so lucky to live in such a diverse. We got four seasons. We're incredibly lucky here. And I didn't think that we would actually consider destroying our environment. It would never happen. You know what I mean? Then I got told that. That Barton Moss is getting down to a critical point down in Barton, and would have come down and show some support to the people. And so I went down and I said he'll go down and show a bit of support. And then you're still going at home, mate?
Yep, still going.
Yeah. And then the next morning, my phone started going. It was the Manchester News have got wind that would have turned up down at Barton Moss. And I've been out to a local village pub in the middle of Wales, you know what I mean? Proper revolutionary pub as well, lovely people. I love the Welsh people, they're great thinkers, and they're ahead of us on this community living site for idea, you know what I mean? There's a lot of people living that lifestyle already down there, so I really like them for that as well, you know what I mean? Because we need more of it. And anyway, I just woke up a bit hungover, really awake about 8 o'clock on Sunday morning in a bit of a grumpy mood, and I started spouting. Now you're asking about, I think it was a bit angry, and one of the angry rants what came out was that I was going to run for Salford and Eccles because I knew that it's down to the local councils whether they're allowed to be tracking goals on in your local area, and I just said it off the cuff and, you know, in an angry rant, and I put the phone down, and I was more worried about the way I spoke to this poor woman journalist because I weren't that nice to her for waking me up. No, I was cursing, swearing at her, you know, for waking me up in the morning, you know, asking what the fuck you're doing, didn't you? No, and I spoke to her quite horribly. I put the phone down. I was more concerned about the way I spoke to this woman rather than the fact that I said I'm thinking, because I'd forgotten all about it. It's all over the place that I'm standing for thinking. I've got such support for the idea that now we've gone beyond that, and we're standing for local council to a full-blown political party now, where some of my ideas, what was like free food, free energy, free drinking water, save the NHS, the jewel in our crown, and privatisation, you know what I mean? Because privatisation ain't freedom, man. It is a form of fascism. And plus, on top of that, they've ended our legal aid system. So, for instance, if you have got a problem, say, with your locals for a fracking well, you've got some problems where, and you want to take them to court to make claims because your family are ill, or you've got rashes or something like that, and you are no longer entitled to legal aid. So we've got all this assault on the working classes and the poor going on, and I thought we've got it's time to stand up and actually do something about the situations, what's going on, before it's too late. And we actually got no freedoms left. We're going to privatise the police, but absolutely privatise everything, you know what I mean? And that don't wash well with me. Like I say, my idea, free public transport, free energy, you know what I mean? I'm against privatisation, you know what I mean? And I think we should be looking at ways where, like I said, acting in community, that's what I was looking at, living for next to nothing, living, like, acting in this community. So we've got to stand against all this madness, what's going on, and try and make change and make a difference. So I like to think I have already had an effect by causing the debate, what I've already created by doing what I'm doing. And if that's all I can do, then I've done my job, because at the end of the day, people have got to speak up for what they think, what they want, and we can't be told by bankers and corporates what we need, and told that we can't join in their society because you ain't got no money. you know what I mean? And you're just left on the scrap heap at the sidelines by, whilst we just keep on getting richer, taking the more, even more piss out of you and taking even more rights and freedoms away from you. So in the end, we'll just be like squashed, like fly on the pavement, you know what I mean? With absolutely no rights whatsoever, no rights to legal aid, no rights to any medical care, absolutely no, even no rights to the police force, because the police force has been privatised as well, you know what I mean? We cannot allow this situation to happen, you know what I mean? So that is what I'm doing, and so for me it's not just about fracking. It's about a lot of things, and for example, I've had people like the fire. When I was in Fleetwood, I came to a local Fleetwood meeting. I had the firefighters come to me and go, "Bez, can you help us as well?" I've had nurses come up to me in Solvent, because they've actually ended now in Solvent. If you're a pregnant woman, you do not get maternity care because they've ended it. There's no more midwives in Salford. You know what I mean? That, imagine that. We cannot accept that as to be normal. You know what I mean? I refuse to accept that the mothers of Salford have got no maternity care anywhere. You know what I mean? That's insane. You know what I mean? So all this shit's going on, and I've got. This is even madder one, who have I come to see me for help, is I had the probation officers, the solicitors and the judges come along and asked me, would I come along and support them as well? Because, you know, with the legal aid system ended there's going to be absolutely nobody, unless you've got money to defend yourself, are going to get any justice anymore in this country. And the only people who are winning are the corporates and the bankers, because they've got these plans like fracking or God knows what else what they've got going on in the mines, you know what I mean? Oh yeah, GM Foods is another thing that I'm standing against, and the same fella called Owen Paterson, he's a conservative lobbyist. He's lobbying Europe at the moment, which is like lobbying means bribery. They've got loads of money, and they lobby people with like, shit, I'll give you a check for 100 grand if you go in there and push for GM crops going in. And this is what he's doing. He's giving money out to Russian GM modified crops. This is how fracking has got into England, you know what I mean? This fella is looking to destroy our natural ecosystem through fracking and bringing GM modified foods, because once the pollen of this GM modified foods goes into the atmosphere and the thing, that's the end of our natural ecosystem. We will not be able to grow organic food anymore, and the only seed we'll be able to buy which will grow is Monsanto seed, which has been GM modified, because this company who want to come into England with the crops is called Monsanto, and they have painted in every fucking seed in the world, so they own the rights to all the seeds in the world. And we cannot have that. So you've got to go to one company only to buy your seed. You've got to buy it every year. It won't be thingy food either, organic. If it's modified food, so it's had most of what you want out of your veg taken away from it. It's been radiated for shelf life. So basically, you're eating dead food. You know what I mean? And this is what they're trying to bring in also. So I'm standing against genetically modified. They're killing off the bee population as well, so we can't pollinate and grow our own food anymore. So there's a lot of issues going on lots of different fronts, where we're slowly being eradicated, more or less, you know what I mean? And I've got no rights because we've got no money. So to me, that is not a situation I think it's healthy for most of the population. So we've got to stand and try and make some change and let them know that we ain't going to be walked over, and we ain't going to be like left on the scrap heap, you know what I mean? And we want our rights, what we're entitled to, and we're willing to fight for it. So we now, the only other party who are against fracking besides myself is the Green Party. And I do like the Green Party and their policies, and I possibly would have joined them, but I want to take it a step further, because what they don't do, what I want to do, is make the bankers pay for their debt. they're sat there making shillions. They're saying how many billions they're going to make from fracking, but it don't come down to the local communities. It's just getting them richer, us even poorer, because like I said before, we've got no rights left. You know what I mean? Because they've been taken off us legally, blah, blah. The NHS has been closed down, privatised. You know what I mean? I know working families, they cannot even feed the both families at work, and they cannot generate enough money for themselves to look after the families. They're struggling at the end of each month. Our first candidate who's running for us is an English teacher, and she can't afford to pay him all, he's feed herself, heat the thing here. And she's an English teacher, you know what I mean? So she's our first candidate who's running in for the Earlham seat for us. So we're out now to try and make real change. We're a political party, and we're going to try and stand up for the people who have got no voice. And hopefully we can bring all these kids who are 16-year-old, people don't vote no more. They've gone in the path of it. They don't care because they think there's nobody they can vote for. But it's now got to a point that it's absolutely crucial that we do something, or otherwise we're going to get the fracked. Everything we've had is going to be taken from us, you know what I mean? So we now can stand united with a party who has got policies and do care for the people. And like I said, the policies are free energy, free food, free drinking water, free public transport, and saving the NHS, you know what I mean? And that's all doable and payable, even if the corporate, if we stay within the present banking system and we've collected all the corporate tax whatsoever, like Google alone owes something like 2 billion, Costco never pay that. Like all these American corporate companies are over here not paying. If they just pay for their taxes alone, that'd be enough to save the NHS and provide free public transport for everybody, you know what I mean? But instead they want to bring out this new law now where they can, if you don't pay the tax, it's like wonga.com, they just go straight in your bank account without permission, no call, and just take your money off you. You know what I mean? But they won't do that to the corporates and the bankers. You know what I mean? The bankers, they're getting what they're worth, trillions and trillions of pounds, getting richer. The poor are getting poorer because we're paying their debt off, because they're trying to say, well, we've got to take responsibility for their shit. Shared responsibility, you know what I mean? And they're like, well, they're not sharing their money out, are they? You know, what are you sharing with us? They're sharing nothing with us, that's what they're sharing, and making us pay. That ain't right. So all these things we want to put right, so if we get power, we can do this job what I want to do, you know what I mean? And which is hopefully create a better place with renewable energy. The bank has been punished as it should have been. The people in government and parliament who helped create this mess, who are partially responsible, punished also, you know what I mean? Because they got away with a hideous crime, scot-free, and don't have to account for what they've done, which is not, that is not what I call, a free society, you know what I mean? Free just society, what's free and just about that, you know what I mean? So they've all more or less been given the license to do whatever they want, with no consequence, and we cannot live in a society like that where we're getting punished to death and they get away scot-free and richer for everything they do. So the reality party is standing against it. And speaking for the people and trying to speak for the rights what we're entitled to.
So it's a long way that you've come from the days in the band, then, isn't it?
Well, yeah, I'm still in the band as well. I do all that, and plus all the other shit I do also, you know what I mean? Because I've just finished building a load of hives, putting three beehives into the schools, along with juices and organic seeds and garden. I'm doing all this with my own money, you know what I mean? I'm raising money by, I'm selling off some paint miracles done by a local artist. The son there done the story, they put £500 contribution. So what I'm hoping to do is roll out permaculture across the nation and try and get it on the school of curriculum so we can teach our young children how to look after themselves, how to grow food for themselves, how to keep bees, the importance of bees, and importance of health and being having your body in an alkaline state. Because what we ain't sold is all these diseases like cancer, diabetes, is caused through having your body in acidic, your body's in an acidic state. And if your body's acidic, you're open to all these diseases. But if you get your body in an alkaline state, this is about prevention. It's been proven by science that cancer, diabetes, and a host of other diseases cannot exist in an alkaline body. So we need to be teaching people about prevention and how to return the bodies in an alkaline state. So this is why I want to go in schools, teach about organic food, know the bees, know, and try and get past this message on how to look after yourselves in the future. Because like the idea goes to food banks, it's not a good idea really, you know what I mean? So you need to take responsibility back for yourself, for feeding yourself, for your own health, you know what I mean? Because like I said, the end of the NHS system and all that. So we need to look at keeping ourselves well and how to do it. And it's simple science, really. You know what I mean? So this is the message what I'm trying to get out there. So, yeah, but that's before I got a fault with it in politics. So I've got all these projects going on, plus now I've got all the politics going on also. So I'm like, I could do with a few extra hours in each day, to be truthful, because I'm not getting enough time to get everything done what I want to do. And like I say, I'm not getting enough time to do what my passion is at the moment, which is permaculture, creating free energy, because that's what my real passion is, and that's what I want to go out. And the thing you go here, I go, oh no, there's that kid again giving free energy away, you know what I mean? How magic would that be? So that wasn't where my dream was coming from, you know what I mean? But now we're like, I'm involved in politics now, you know what I mean? Through a mad run of events, really. So here I am, at Fleetwood Football Club, the home of the Cod Army. Cod Army! Cod Army!
So we've got the event on the weekend coming up.
Yeah.
What's, are you going to be here? Are you going to be doing...
This weekend, is it?
The anti-fracking...
Fracking Sunday.
Yeah.
Well, of course I'll be here. We've got some really good speakers who are going to speak in between each band. Maybe have a few short films and people who don't know about fracking, we hopefully can bring attention to them, right? So, and we've got some great bands on and a great day of music, hopefully. And a bit of Fleetwood sunshine, we hope.
Well, thanks for sitting down and having a chat.
All right, mate, not a problem. And thanks for listening to us. I hope you've got enough information there for your readers.
I'm going to hit stop on that one.